moment we've all been waiting for, because last October, we launched our very special Awesome Orbit competition with Tim Peake, and we asked you all to design an emblem showing how you think satellites could be used in the future.
Yes, believe it or not, that emblem will be engraved onto an actual satellite, now stay with me, which will be attached to an actual rocket that will be launched into actual space. Seriously.
Wow. Yeah, that's not actually it, Richie, because our winner has a money cannot buy prize, because they'll be given a trip on a driverless car, which is controlled by a satellite, as well as that they'll be given the behind-the-scenes tour of a satellite facility, as well as that they're also going to be able to control a Mars rover on planet Earth. That is very, very cool. I would like to win.
It's such an incredible prize, and no wonder thousands of you entered. So, our judges had a really, really difficult time whittling it down to a top 30, but after days of sleepless nights trying to pick, they got there eventually. This is your top 30.
Yes, and you had so many incredible ideas, some satellites helping to clear the ocean and some to help fight fires. It's creative, it's clever.
Yeah, they're wonderful. There's going to be Sit the Squid any second, and there's going to be one that cleans up the viruses around. Oh, there it is, Sit the Squid, and there are viruses that are detected by satellites. There are all sorts. It's absolutely wonderful. And not only that, but every single one of those designs has earned themselves one of these. The orange competition badge. Wait, wait, wait. But it doesn't stop there. All 30 of you that just appeared there, your name is going to be engraved on the satellite that is going to be going around the world 15 times a day.
Yeah. That is so cool. So cool. Do you need the top three?
I think we should do the top three, shouldn't we? Let's stop this delay. Right. In the in third place, and the top entry from the 6 to 8 category is Ava.
Yeah!
Love that. Now, what an atmosphere! What an atmosphere! Now, Ava's design is called Where Bees Belong, and her satellite would help search for land that needs more flowers to be planted, helping out pollinators like bees.
That's so good. That's so good. And now we have second place and the top entry from the 12 to 15 category, which is Adam!
Wow, I'd just like to say a big thanks to my mom for helping me find my felted pens, and my dad for, you know, giving me snacks.
Adam,
it's just so good. And
it's not you,
my dear. Thank you so much.
This Adam's design is called Ace of Space and would be used to help repair broken satellites in space. And guess what?
What?
Both of our runners-up are here right now in studio. Isn't that right, Adam Beale?
Yes, that's right, Moxie. I'm here with Adam and Ava. Guys, congratulations. The designs are unbelievable. Ava, how does it feel to have your own orange badge?
It's amazing, because this is my first ever badge.
Your first ever badge is the orange badge. What a goal. And Adam, your names are going to be sent into space. What do you think about that?
I mean, it's amazing, but it's out of this world.
It is out of this world. Give it up one more time for our runners-up, Adam and Ava.
Oh, congratulations. Now it's time to reveal the winner.
Yes.
In five, four, three, two, one, zero. Woo! Okay, now from the 9 to 11 category, the winner is Bethany!
Yeah!
Woo! Come on over, Bethany! Join us!
Congratulations!
Well, congratulations! Welcome to Blue Pizza. Richie, are you seeing what I'm seeing?
What's that? Look at all those badges!
Oh my gosh, I'm very impressed. Now, your design is going to be engraved on a satellite and sent into space. That's a big deal. How do you feel?
It's amazing. I'm so excited.
Oh, wow.
Not only that, but the satellite itself is going to... You're going to be a part of history, because that satellite is the first one ever to be launched from the UK. So, how does that sound?
It's amazing,
right?
Yeah.
Now, let's get into the design itself, shall we? Moxie, will you do the honours?
I would love to. Ready? Boom!
Magic. Look at it. It's beautiful.
Amazing.
Now, it's called Earth Sitter, right? So, what was your inspiration behind it? Talk us through it.
So I was thinking maybe like when you babysit someone, you're like caring for them, so you're caring for the Earth, so you're like sitting for it.
That's magic. So cool. And now tell us, what exactly does your satellite do?
So it scans the Earth and it tells people back at the base where illegal deforestation is happening, and so they can then go and plant new trees.
God, you know your stuff. And you're a fan of all things space, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, here's the proof, because this is your bedroom at home,
and
it is all things spacey. Look at that duvet set. Pretty good. Now, I'm going to ask you a question that I feel is quite silly and obvious, but I'm going to ask you anyway. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Definitely an astronaut.
Definitely. That's is why we love you here. Now, speaking of astronauts, we've got a little surprise for you. Ooh. Coming from the International Space Station, check out this.
Hello, Bethany. I'm ESA astronaut Matthias Mauder, and I heard the brilliant news about you winning the Blue Peter Space Competition. And I thought, where could be the best place to congratulate you from, but here in space. I'm currently orbiting the Earth 16 times a day, and I know the satellite featuring your emblem will be traveling around at the same speed, and I'll keep a lookout for it. I hope the rest of your experience is very special on Earth, and congratulations again. All the best from ISS, and goodbye.
A message
from space! How do you feel?
It's amazing.
Oh, amazing.
Listen, one more time, please make some noise for Bethany!
Done, Bethany. There are some incredible designs right there.